declaration statement from your side.
There is too much of background noise or mic noise.
गुड इवनिंग सर।
Sir, if you're speaking anything, we can't hear anything. हेलो हेलो, नाउ ऑडिबल नहीं स्टिल?
इट
इज नॉट क्लियर सर।
इट इज क्लियर,
वी विल सी, वी विल सी कि
इट इज क्लियर सर।
अदरवाइज आई विल जॉइन वन सेकंड, नो प्रॉब्लम। सो टुडे वी विल सी सम मोर क्वेश्चंस ऑन दिस। नाउ लास्ट सेशन वाज ऑन सम ऑफ रूट्स एंड प्रोडक्ट्स ऑफ रूट्स एंड रिलेशन बिटवीन दिस द कोफिशिएंट्स वैल्यू, बेसिकली रिलेशंस बिटवीन एबीसी एंड अल्फा बीटा। अल्फा बीटा वेयर roots of equation or we can say zeros also, or solutions of quadratic equation. We'll see some question, then we'll move to next, our final topic for this chapter, division algorithm for polynomials. Fine, let us start.
So should we switch on the video?
Video you can switch on. In case now you have genuine issue, otherwise in case network is low or poor, then you can switch off the video. Otherwise, it should always be on. That is, you can say one thing you have to keep in mind while attending the online sessions. Already we have online, lot of limitations are there. Like we just seen, voice was not clear, some other disturbance. From our side, we have to try data. We have this maximum authentication for this session. See, let us solve some questions. Find the zeros of the given polynomials and verify. Simply I am writing and verify the results and verify the results. Verify the results means, verify the results means we have to take sum of roots and alpha beta, and then we have to check with minus b by a. If it's coming, then it's verified. Product of roots should come equal to c by a. The first one, suppose you have 4u square plus 8u. 4u square plus 8u, first we'll see 4u square plus 8u, everyone will try and let me know the answers. What is the value of zeros of this given polynomial? Given polynomial is basically quadratic polynomial because degree is 2, and here we will find zero's value. Chanchal, Tushar, Hemant, everyone will try. Ahil, Steve, Mohammed, Yamd, Diksha. I think normally if you observe, no, then you will get the values within 5 to 10 seconds. Please share me answer in chat, that you can send me the answer. Okay, Diksha, I got answer from Diksha. Good, Diksha. Samarth also have shared me the answer. I will explain him, no problem. If the students are not fine, those who are not getting the answer, no problem. I will see, I will explain. But last 1 minute for you to try. Then we see Anudhi, Pratibha, Pratusha. JBM, Asia. No problem, Rashul, we see. Tandi. Only two students got the answer, Samarth and Diksha. Rashin also shared me the answer. Okay. Okay, now we see how that will be the answer. See. This is basically quadratic question because a is not 0, a is 4, because the terms associated with coefficient of a square means x square is a. Here the polynomial equation is in terms of u, so we can write pu. We can write pu because it is equation is in terms of u. 4u square plus 8u, right? We have to find the zeros value. The zeros means y is 0, then we have to find x value. So this pu will be 0. And we have to find u value for which pu is 0. So we can take 0 is equal to 4u square plus 8u. Now this equation becomes quadratic equation because right hand side is 0, means pu 0, then polynomial equation converts to quadratic equation. This was quadratic polynomial, qp, quadratic polynomial. Now when this pu is replaced with 0, then it becomes quadratic equation. Now we can simplify the equation to get the zero's value. We can take 4u common and u plus 2. 4u common, u plus 2. Okay. So this way 4 will come down. So 0 by 4 u plus 2. So 0 by 4 is 0 basically. 0 by 4 is 0. No problem. 0 is equal to u plus 2. So one value will be, say, product r equal to 0. So this will be u 0 or u plus 2 0. So u 0 or u equal to minus 2. So these are the two values of zeros for the given quadratic polynomial, 0 and minus 2 simply. 0 and minus 2. Because 4u square plus 8u we can assume as pu, because this given power quadratic, this is given quadratic polynomial, we can is in terms of u, so we can take pu is equal to 4u square plus 8u. Now we have to find zero's value. Zero's value means the values of u for which pu is 0, that we know. So pu we can assume as 0, or we can say pu is given 0. So this we can simplify. For u we can take common, u plus 2, then 0 by 4 will be 0, equal to u in bracket u plus 2. So 0 will be u or u plus 2 0. So it is basically 0 or minus 2. So these are two zeros value for this question. Now I'll see a relation between zeros and a relation between zeros and this one roots, basically roots or zeros, and this one coefficient of x square x and constant value. Now we can check and verify whether it is coming equal or not. So see, 0 minus 2 is the one value. Now we can write here, let alpha equal to 0 and beta equal to minus 2. So alpha plus beta will equal to minus 2. 0 plus minus 2, 0 minus 2 is minus 2 basically. Minus b by a, we have to check and verify it is equal to minus b by a or not. See, minus b, b value will be 8, because normal equation is x square plus bx plus c equal to 0, quadratic equation. So a will be associated
sir,
with
x. Sir, how do you get minus b by a?
Minus b by a is the or formula. No? Last session we didn't attend this.
Okay, sir.
Last session we have seen alpha plus beta, sum of root is minus b by a, and product of root is c by a. Last two sessions was on this formula only. So sum of root is minus b by a. So minus b will be 8, because if we compare with the standard equation, to a will be 4 and b will be 8. So minus 8, a will be 4. Minus 8 by 4 is minus 2. That means correct, hence verified. And also we see product of roots, alpha beta. Alpha beta if you do 0, because 0 into minus 2 is 0, will be equal to c by a. Because it should be equal to c by a, then only it is verified. So c will be 0, because no constant term is there, right? So right, Sarah, your answer is correct. So c by a, so no constant value is there, so c will be basically 0. So here 0 by 4, that means 0. 0 by 4 will be 0, because c is basically constant term, and no constant term is there, that means c is 0. Because 4u square plus 8u, we can write 0 additional value from our side. C will be 0, 0 by 4 will be 0.
So can you explain
that
once again?
Okay. See. So given equation was 4e square plus 8u, and this was the question. And you have to find zeros of this equation. First thing is, this will be a quadratic polynomial because degree is 2. Right. And for zeros, now we know, for any polynomial, we have to find zeros value. So from graph also we have seen, the graph cutting or meeting x-axis will be having, that point will be zero value, we can say. So this graph is cutting x-axis, that means, suppose you have this type of graph, so this is cutting at x-axis, this means at this point y will be zero, x will be some values, but x-axis, y-axis, but y will be zero. Similarly, y is basically this one, py is basically y. This is equation y equal to x square plus bx plus c. This was, we have seen in our graph, representation or a graphical solution in which this was quadratic or the curve will be parabola. So y is basically pu or px. So y is 0. So we'll put pu as 0 to find u value. Always to find the zeros value, we'll take pu or px 0. So because this quadratic equation or quadratic polynomial is in terms of u, we'll take pu. We'll assume pu equal to this. Pu means polynomial in terms of u. You can assume two polynomial in terms of u is given 4u square plus 8u. Now this left side is 0. So 0 equal to 4u square plus 8u. Now we can simplify. We simplified and we can find the values of u. 4u you can take common to u plus 2. Now this 0 by 4 will go down to 0 by 4 equal to u in bracket. It's not u plus 2. So 0 by 4 is 0. U in bracket u plus 2. So this product is 0 now. See, a into b is 0, we can say a 0 or b 0, either one 0, a 0 or b 0. Similarly, u into u plus 2 0, so either u 0 or this total summation u plus 2 0. From this we got u equal to 0, and from here we will get value u equal to minus 2. Correct. And these were the basically roots or zeros of the given quadratic polynomial. We can assume as alpha beta. First root we can take alpha, second one beta. So alpha beta we got basically roots or zeros are same. Alpha is 0, beta is minus 2. You know sum of roots, alpha plus beta. Sum of roots will be 0, minus 2, minus 2. And it should be equal to minus b by our formula. So minus b will be 8 plus 8, minus plus 8 will be minus 8 by a is 4. So this is minus 2. That means equal, correct. means verified. And then we have product of roots alpha into beta, C by A, alpha beta 0 into minus 2 0, and C by A. C is basically, you can say 0, because complete quadratic equation is AX square plus BX plus C. C is constant value. Here, C value is not given. That means we can take as 0. So C is 0. So 0 by 4 will be 0. So again, we can say hence verified, because both sum of roots is coming equal to minus B by A, and product of roots is coming C by A. That means verified. Fine. Shall we see next question? Any doubt still? You have any doubt, then please ask. Otherwise, we can solve one more question.
No doubt, sir. You might continue.
Okay. Similar type of question, we'll see once again. So next question. For this also, question will be same, statement will be same. Just I'll write in this one. Polynomial basically, t square minus 15 is the value. Let me take otherwise a simple case, because some students are finding difficulty. Let me take simple case, because all the two sessions we have for this zeros now. So no problem, we can see simple question once, then we move to different questions. This is polynomial equation in terms of x. Now everyone should get the answer. This is standard quadratic polynomial, we can say. We can assume this as Px. Px means polynomial in terms of x. And we can find the zeros value by assuming Px equal to 0. Those, then only we can find zeros. Or for finding zeros, means by indirectly in question they have given
x is 0. 2 and 4.
Okay. Minus 2 and 4. Okay. So others can also try. And okay, Sarah, this time we'll solve, next time we'll solve this question that you have shared with me. No problem. This one, everyone will try. Eksha got the answers, Samarth also. I want the answer from all of you. Pratibha got the answer correct. Especially Hemant. The last time Hemant asked me this previous question. So Hemant, Chanchal, everyone should get this answer. Alpha, beta, we can say, or zeros of this quadratic polynomial. Right version, correct. So five of you have replied me the correct answer. Sarah, Sumit, Diksha, Pratusha, Pratibha, six of you, the Russian. Because 17, 18 are still remaining. Okay, Sarah, your answer is correct. Angela also. Correct. Xavier, Amdav, Tushar, Tanvi, Teja. What is the answer? Steve. Rush. Sorry. Rashul Sharma, Pratusha. While your answer also correct, 10 of, almost 10 of you have shared me the answer, but 13 is still remaining. Without any difficulty, you can use splitting middle term or quadratic formula also to get the zeros value. Even your answer is not correct. So one second, please solve. One second, verify the answer. And after getting the answer, now you can verify the results by taking sum of roots and making it equal to, or verify means checking whether sum of roots equal to minus b by a and product of roots equal to c by a or not. Now let me solve this question. See, we say let px, because see, this is quadratic polynomial, no doubt, because degree is 2 and is in terms of x. So we'll take px as x square minus 2x minus 8. X square minus 2x minus 8. Now, one line we write for finding zeros of this quadratic polynomial, zeros of the given quadratic polynomial px will be equal to 0. Px will be equal to 0, then we can find the zeros value. 0 will be equal to x square, equation will be simplified to 0, x square minus 2x minus 8. Now we can use splitting middle term. So 2, we have to find 2 by addition or subtraction, and minus 2 basically, and product should be minus 8x square, not minus 8, minus 8x square. So what will be the value? We connect 8 as 4 into 2, and 4 minus 2 will be 2. 8 is basically, we can write that as 2 into 4, and 4 minus 2 is 2. We write 0 equal to x square, minus is sign, so minus 4x plus 2x minus 8. So 0 equal to, we can take from these two terms, we can take x common, x minus 4. From these two terms, we can take 2 common, x minus 4. So 0 equal to, from say, these two terms, we can take common, x minus 4. So this remaining will be x plus 2. The remaining will be x plus 2. So 0 equal to, these are multiplied. So we can write this as, here x minus 4 equal to 0, or see, always now we have to remember that is a into b is 0, that either one is 0, that is a 0 or b equal to 0, not both, because 0 into 0 is not defined. What is the value? That's why we write either one means a 0 or b 0. So 0 into 0 is indeterminate form, you can say, or not defined. So that's why we write like this, a 0 or b 0, either any one will be 0, not both. So this x plus 2 will be 0. So we take x equal to 4 or x equal to minus 2. So we got this roots value, hence roots are x equal to 4 comma minus 2. This will be two values of roots, because degree is 2, so 2 roots will get. Now we'll verify these roots by having this sum of roots and product of roots value. Simply say, question was simple, and we can say minus 2x we have to operate by plus minus, and minus 8x square by multiplication. So it is 4 into 2. So minus 4x plus 2x, minus 4x plus 2x will be minus 2x, that is our required value. For verifying, we will see alpha plus beta. So one will take alpha, other term will take beta. Like alpha is 4 and beta is minus 2. So alpha plus beta will be 2, 4 minus 2, equal to, it should be equal to minus b by a, 4 equal to minus b by a. So minus b is minus 2 and a is 1. So like minus 1 minus 2 is plus 2, correct. So that means it is matching value. And then product of roots, we can see alpha into beta, that is equal to minus 8. That should be equal to c by a. So c is basically minus 8 only. So minus 8, a is 1, because coefficient of x square is a. Coefficient of x square is a. So a is coefficient of x square, that is 1. That is minus 8. Hence, we can say alpha plus beta is coming equal to minus b by a. Alpha into beta is coming c by a. Hence, verified. We can write, hence, verified. Same process for all the questions we have to follow. Please note the solution and any doubt, and please ask. Those who got the answer correctly, they can put this tick mark like this. any notebook. And those who didn't got the answer, please note the solution and ask if you have any doubt. Tushar answer is correct, right? Tushar. -2 is one value and other will be 4. We can use quadratic formula also, but this is simple, especially medium. 2 we have to obtain and 8. So 8 by product minus 8 and then by addition or subtraction minus 2x. So 4 into 2 minus 4x, which will be middle terms. Now one question I got from Sarah, so we'll see first that question, then we'll see other questions. Let me write that question and then you all can try.
Sir, can you once repeat?
Yes, I'm saying we'll see one question from Sarah you have shared and then we'll move on to next question, other questions. So question is basically same question, you have to find zeros values of 4s square minus 4s plus 1. This is the question. 4s square minus 4s plus 1. We have to find the zeros of this polynomial and then we have to verify the results. 4s square minus 4s plus 1, correct. All things are same, just your question is this one. Right, this was second one, then I connect this is third one. Similar type of question. What is the square minus 4s plus 1? Is the question you have to find 0, 0?
Would be 1 by 2.
Okay. Both the roots will be, both the zeros will be 1 by 2. You are saying
something. Yeah, equal roots.
Equal roots. Okay. Fine. So others will also solve this question. Pratibha also got the answer right. Pratusha also 1 by 2, 1 by 2. Karitiksha also. Prashan also 1 by 2. Correct. Right. Is everyone is having the right answer? 1 by 2. Last 1 minute. Then we'll discuss this question. So I will also solve for Sarah because this was one question she asked me. What is square minus 4s plus 1? See. Net, because this now polynomial is having degree 2 means quadratic polynomial and is in terms of s. We'll take let ps equal to 4s square minus 4s plus 1. Correct. For getting zeros values, we'll take now ps will be equal to 0. Because to finding the zero, for finding the zeros value, we have to assume ps as 0, or we can say it's given only ps 0 so that we can find the values of 0. Zeros of this quadratic polynomial, this equation will become quadratic equation then 4s plus 1 equal to 0. Now we have two methods basically. Splitting minimum, three methods actually. Splitting minimum we can use or quadratic formula or we can have direct formula also. See, let me show you one by one. First method is splitting minimum. So 4s square. Here we have minus 4s. Minus 4 is there. So minus 4s we have to write in addition or subtraction. And product should be not 1, 4s square. Product is a into c. Right, then we also correct answer. So product will be a into c. So basically product should be coming 4s square. So minus we can take 2s and minus 2s. Simple, because minus 2s and minus 2s if we multiply, no? So this will get 4s square because product should become equal to product should be equal to this value 1 and 4s square. So product should come equal to 4s square and addition value equal to minus 4s. Minus 2s, minus 2s. Right. And then this will be plus 1 equal to 0. So for first two terms, we can take 2s common. So 2s minus 1. Here we can take minus common, minus 1 basically. Because again, now this will come here. Again, this will come here. So this will be minus, if you take minus 1, then 2s minus 1 equal to 0. So now 2s minus 1 will be common from both the terms, 2s minus 1, then 2s minus 1 equal to 0. So one value will be 2s minus 1 equal to 0, or again 2s minus 1 equal to 0. So from here we can have this s value equal to 1 by 2. Here we can have s value equal to 1 by 2. This is both the zeros are equal, and we can say equal roots, s will be equal to 1 by 2 comma 1 by 2. Simple, because 2s equal to 1, 2s minus 1, 0 means 2s equal to 1, and s will be equal to 1 by 2. Here also 2s will be equal to 1, s value equal to 1 by 2. Simple. Minus 4s we connect, minus 2s, minus 2s. And then we will get the values. Sum of roots equal to 1, right? So this was the first method actually. Now we will move to second method for solving this question. This was the first method. We will see second method now. What is second method? Second method, we can see, we can use, it's the quadratic formula if we want. 4s square minus 4s plus 1, 0. So this s will be equal to, by a quadratic formula, if you see, so s will be minus b means 4. Formula is basically x is equal to minus b plus minus root of b square minus 4ac by 2a, b square minus 4ac by 2a, for equation of x square plus bx plus c equal to 0. For this equation, similar to this equation, matching value basically. The equation is same, just in place of x, they have used s as the variable. So this will be minus b means 4 plus minus b square means 16 minus 4 square 16 minus 4 into a is 4 into c, that is 1, divided by, we can divide it 2a, 2 divided by, this value will be divided by 2 into a is 4, okay. So this will be 4 plus minus, say this will be 16 minus 16, 4 plus 16 divided by 8, so this will be 4 plus minus 0, because this value is 0, this one value is 0 by 8, that is 1 by 2. So 1 by 2 is the value, but we know here, okay, this is degree 2, means s square is here, that means degree is 2. So degree 2 means 2 zeros will come, 2 zeros will come, 1 zero will got 1 by 2, means equal roots basically, both these zeros will be 1 by 2 and 1 by 2 only, 1 by 2 and 1 by 2 only. And how we can say, also we can see this one value 0. That's also, because of that also we can say zeros will be same, equal roots we can say. Last method we can say, third one. What is third method? See, equation was 4s square minus 4s plus 1 equal to 0. Because PS is 0 for finding the zeros value. Now we can see, if we carefully notice, we can write 4s as 2s square. We can write 4s as 2s square, 4s square is 2s square minus 2 into this will be, two into 2s, 2 into a into b, and then into 1. Why 1? Why 1? Because we have this 4s. So 2 into 2s is 4s. So only 1. Say this will be a square minus 2 into a into b. This is b. And then we have formula b square. B square means 1 square. B square is this one. B square is this one. So we got this formula as a square minus 2ab plus b square. We got 2s. So this will be 2s minus 1 whole square equal to 0. So this will be the value because a minus b whole square. We write this as 2s minus 1. So a square minus 2ab plus b square. A square minus 2ab plus b square. So this is basically a minus b whole square. We got 2s square is 4s square. 2ab, 2 into 2s into b. B is 1 because already it is 2 into 2s is 4s, so only 1 we can write. Then we will get 1, so 1 square is fine, 1 square is matching 1 value. So 2s minus 1 square, that is 2s minus 1, 2s minus 1 equal to 0, same thing, s will be equal to 1 by 2, comma 1 by 2. These are the three methods for finding the zeros value. Now we can verify the results. So verifying is very easy. So we can say let alpha one root 1 by 2, beta another root 1 by 2. So sum of roots will be alpha plus beta 1. And minus b by a we will write here, minus b by a value. So minus of b. B is basically, if we match with the standard equation, so a will find a will be 4, b will be minus 4, c will be 1. With the standard equation, if we match, a will be 4, b will be minus 4, c will be 1. So minus of b, so b is 4, so minus of, not 4, minus 4, b is minus 4, minus of minus 4, that we have to say minus of minus 4 by 4, that is equal to 1. Hence we can say alpha plus beta equal to minus b by a. Product of roots alpha into beta equal to c by a. So alpha into beta is 1 by 4 and c by a also we can find. C is here 1, c is 1, no problem. So 1 by a is 4, 1 by 4 is the value. Right. So we have verified the results. That is alpha plus beta is going to minus b by a, alpha beta c by a. Verified. Right, Sarah. So any doubt between any of the methods, second method, first method, third method?
Not yet, sir.
Come on.
No, sir.
No problem, sir. See, so any methods now we can apply, and most for as per CBC board is concerned, no, we have to stick with the pattern or the method which is there in the book or within the syllabus. So that method only we have to follow. It is recommended so that we get full out of full marks. Because what happens now in answer sheet also, this one teacher get this answer sheet while checking the answers of board papers. So they have the answers from NCERT textbook only. So follow the same method, then they will give maximum marks. If methods are different, normally they give marks, but in some cases they can deduct the marks in some cases. So it's better to not to take any risk and follow the same method. But many methods are there to solve any question.